My name is Jules. I'm a Radiant player. If you're enjoying this type of content, be sure to like and subscribe, considering 80% of you guys are still not subscribed. I do these coaching sessions live, so you're more than welcome to swing by the stream and ask questions. If you're interested in coaching yourself, click the link in the description, click the book a lesson button, and select your plan and time. Lastly, if you want a chance to win free coaching, be sure to comment down below your Discord name and why you think you deserve it. I'll be picking out a person randomly. Other than that, enjoy the video. Reyna Einails? Yeah, Reyna Einails. Here, this is for you, Shaiko. I'm flashing. I'm flashing. All right. Let's hop into the coaching session, shall we? Okay, so silver 3. Nice. Did you recently peak this?
I just got to silver 3 last night.
Nice. All right, so you're upward. Oh, yeah. 58. Okay, so 58% win rate. Pretty good start to the act. I would say, yeah, pretty good. 130 damage per round. Okay, so this, okay, controller main looks like a omen. And then, okay, so when do you play Reyna?
I sometimes play with my friend and we will swap off. So when she wants to play omen, I'll play Reyna.
Okay. I see. Okay. That's fine. All right. Yeah, your win percentage is pretty high. Damage round on Reyna is pretty good. The only thing that's like alarming right now, setting off some red flags, is this headshot percentage. 8%. That's pretty low. Either these guys are wearing a lot of helmets and or you know, maybe we're aiming at a little bit too many toes. But yeah, usually the headshot percentage, like, it's a good indicator of crosshair placement, right? Like, if you have naturally good crosshair placement, you're gonna have pretty high headshot percentage, so that's probably like the biggest thing I'm gonna be looking for. Yeah, because usually you want to aim for like 20, right? 20 to 30%. That's like ideal. KD though isn't too bad. 0.87. It's a little bit low. If you could go for like 1 KD, that's like perfect. And then damage per round, anything above 140 is good on controllers. So do you slurp your water or gulp it? Enemy spot. Hold on. I gotta focus up on this.
Spike planted.
Yeah, that was. Once you get your trail marked and I started to hear the dog, I probably would have prioritized the dog before you started to peek. You were kind of like on a ticking time bomb there, you know, like.
Yeah.
At best, you get one and then the dog gets you and then you die. So you want to go with, instead of full armor Spectre, you want to go light armor Vandal. You always want to prioritize light armor Vandal over full armor Spectre. This round, I would go full armor, yeah, because you can afford it. But I'm just saying, when you can't afford it, instead of going Spectre full armor, you want to go light armor Vandal.
Okay.
Face your fear.
Oh.
Enemy spotted me.
Okay.
Enemy spotted me.
Yeah, you might be able to push
spike
up here.
Down,
yep. Yeah. I like this. I like this a lot.
Oh, well.
All good. Yeah, so a couple things I'm noticing with the gun control, insta crouching, right? And you can be a little bit more patient. You could be a little bit more patient with your crosshair. Don't be afraid to just take your time, aim for their head, and then just kind of, you know, let it rip. But don't worry too much about that, honestly. Actually, I wouldn't mind it at all. Oh, this is a good flash. Oh, this is good. I love this play. Oh my goodness. Oh, I saw the future. I saw it. Oh my goodness. I knew it. Before, that was such a good round. That was such a good, everything up, like literally as you're walking up to the wall, I see you pulling up the flash. I'm like, this is going to be good. This is going to be good. As soon as you flash, you TP in, I was like, this is going to be really, really good. Like, I literally just saw it. That was really good. Really great rounds. I love that. Could be mid. Okay. I actually like this. I think they could have...
fear. Yeah, so I'm noticing it's the crosshair placement that's aiming at the chest, relying on the recoil to bring it up to the headshots. Yeah, okay. Alright, nice try, nice try. I think you might have been able to get away with that ult. I don't know if the fade would have turned around.
No, I've been burned too many times. Yeah, but you true, know, I true, still true. Do it sometimes.
Yeah, no, I get that, I get that. One thing I am noticing with a lot of your aim is like you're always aiming like chest level, and then you shoot, and then you allow your recoil to bring it up to the headshots. You know what I'm saying? Rather than just aiming at the headshots and pulling down the recoil. And don't worry, I'll show you in a custom game exactly what I'm talking about. All right, plebs, if you're not subbed, I'm sorry. You can always sub for free on Twitch Prime. But a 60 second ad redeem has been issued, so. Nice. So Meether, thanks for the primer, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Remaining. Oh!
A shot.
Careful.
Yeah, play the bomb if you can. Yeah, so one thing to do, like, if you hear him like sprinting at you, don't be afraid to just, you know, play ring around the rosy, right? And just avoid him. Because you know that they have to tap the bomb, so then you get to play around that. Like, you can just avoid all sorts of gunfights. Spinning your mouse is the only thing that makes sense to me.
Cover going out. Cover going out.
Okay. Yeah, she's close to me. Yeah. Wait, there's three. Oh my god, these guys are rotating really quick. All right. Next round, we're gonna try something. We're gonna lurk. These guys are over rotating. Whenever I notice that teams are over rotating, we're gonna start lurking a little bit. All right. Yeah, walk. Yeah, leave. Nice.
I don't know where to go.
It's fine. You can walk a mid. Walk. Yeah.
The carrier is dead.
I have the spike. Spike down A.
Shadow's traveling.
Yeah, you're gonna have to walk up mid here and try and get a kill. Nice. You can go B, maybe ult the bomb.
Yeah.
Okay, and plant out in the open, like right here, yeah. So ult the bomb and plant right here.
Watch them run. I have the spike.
And you have to go aggressive a little bit somewhere. Yeah, you gotta look for more. Maybe wait here. See what you hear.
Three killed.
Oh,
nice try.
So, idea was good. Yeah, so when you're down in a 1v3 situation like this, you have to go aggressive. Otherwise, like if you're playing back site and you're playing off the bomb, they're going to trade you out, right? They're just going to pinch you. So you have to kind of like make a play and force the isolation, right? Force the 1v1 isolations. But it was a good try. Okay, well, Jet's not about it, so it's all good. You can go with her. Yeah, run with the Jet here. You want to trade her death. Yeah, smoke, yep. One close right. Nice, good trade.
I was a little lost.
You're good. Okay, Brim, you have ults. Okay, you can ult bomb. Yeah.
Down A.
Okay.
Welcome to my world.
Viper probably ults in the bomb.
Where? No way!
Yeah. You're good. Alright, winnable.
Cover going out.
Last player standing.
You got this.
Blue Jays gifted a tier 1 sub to Spainsinsksaj. They have given 19 gift subs in the channel. Blinding.
One enemy remaining.
No one's pinging!
No one's pinging.
No! Oh my god.
Let's go. Let's go.
I almost stopped to ping it myself and I'm like, that's stupid.
All good. All good. All good. All good. Nice round.
Oh my god.
You got some L teammates, that's for sure. But hey, 1v2, nice round. See if you can fight this Nest person when the brim swings. Oh, never mind. Okay, walk. Tuck back in. Tuck back in the corner, yeah. And chill. See if you catch this Reyna. Never mind. You hear him flanking. Yep. Careful. He's gonna walk to mid doors. I think he might have already crossed. Yeah, he did. Yeah, hold the left side, yeah.
One enemy remaining.
Nice. Last one was sight somewhere. Careful, she's probably gonna peek you.
Last player standing.
You have a flash. Yeah, flash. Oh,
No, the time.
I think if you flash a little bit earlier.
Ace. Yeah. Another ace. Oh.
Defenders it's all good. Win. Anyway, it's all good. Honestly, I think this was a great game, all things considered, that Reyna was, had 40 kills. So.
A little smelly, yeah.
Yeah, a little smelly. A little bit of a rat, but it's all good. It's all good. Yeah, she had 43 kills. So. Honestly, I think you played really well. Okay, so. One thing that I'm noticing with your aim is like a lot of times you come around the corner and you're peeking new angles and you're aiming at the chest. So you do something like this. But you see like you get the headshot, but it's only because the recoil is hitting it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's okay sometimes, but for the most part, you should be aiming for what you should be doing. Is aiming for head and then pulling it down. So like this. You never want to just let your crosshair do this, right? You never want to let your shots do this. You basically just, you want to pull your crosshair down a bit. And you can practice this, of course, in the wall, right? Another thing too. So strafing. This is something that you should start doing, especially if you don't plan on spraying. So if you plan on bursting, right? Like this. Instead of standing still while you're bursting, you can do the exact same fire rate, but moving, you know? This way, like, in between shots that you would be doing with your burst, you're moving and it displaces your head. It's harder for you for them to kill you. And you still have the same fire rate, right? Like, see? This is the exact same fire rate, but you're moving in between the shots. So, you're allowing your recoil to kind of reset when you're doing this. How do you know what's good crosshair placement? Well, this map is kind of tricky because they can have all sorts of different angles here, but just making sure that you are envisioning them being exactly where you think they are, right? Like as you're coming around the corner in your mind, you should be thinking, okay, if he peeks, am I ready for this, right? So sometimes I'm noticing, you know, you come up like this, you come up through mid double doors and you're kind of just like this, and this is like chest level, like body level, right? And you want to just be like a little bit higher. And just always just be thinking like, you know, head level. And the best way of doing this, running around the map and, or I guess because you don't know exactly where it is yet, you can always go into death matches and like before you peek corners, ask yourself, is this head level? And then when you peek someone, don't even shoot, don't even do anything. Just find out, just be like, was this on his head? If not, where's the adjustment, right? And then just keep doing that in these death matches. And that's the best way of getting it down. And then after you have that down and you understand where the head level is, then you can practice it by going into a custom and doing this, right? You're just running around, you know, you can even do it with the knife out. You don't have to have the gun out. Well, I guess the speed does help, but and this way I'm just like, okay, head level. And it starts to become like second nature. Like I could be in a call, I could be watching anime, I could be in a Netflix, whatever, and I could still do this, like, just because I've played this game too much. But yeah, smoke off B right away or smoke off A right away, probably. and then, you know, you can kind of just chill, you can do whatever. Just make sure you're not ever caught out in this area where you could just be like, you know, you did this one time where you're like, all right, I'm gonna sit here and then wait for a sound. It's like, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which, you know, I get your logic. You're like, well, I don't want to smoke if no one's there, but okay, what happens if they walk up on you, right? You gotta think like all the options here, right? How do I get punished? And this is how you get punished if they walk up. So run through all of these ideas in your head about like, what are the chances? Like, if we could run this through a simulator and they could do every single option, will I get punished for this play? And how do I get punished for this play? And if there is an option that you get punished by anything, you should be like, okay, well, I should probably not be doing it, right? Like, so yeah, smoking there is probably not the most ideal. Another instance would be like, you know, if you're up here and you're just kind of waiting for someone and you have nobody mid, you're going to be thinking, well, how do I get punished from this area? Well, I could think of two ways. One, if they have a sky and they pop flash me here, that would suck. If they lurk up mid, I'm exposed for mid, that would suck. So how do I avoid that? Well, probably wouldn't play here. I'd play at the end here. So if I get pop flash, I can drop instantly. That's one case. You've already fixed one of the options. Boom. Now, how do you deal with this? Getting exposed from tunnel. Two options. One, you should only do this at the start of the round when you know that they can't actually physically be there, or you can smoke it off. So boom, just like that. All of the options where you could have gotten punished, you now cannot get punished for it, right? So it's just like that. Just running through these scenarios in your head can really just impact how you play, and it's such a small change, right? What is like the change between playing up here and playing back here is only a couple steps, but the idea behind it is huge, right? Does that make sense? So it's like such a small difference between here and here, but such a huge impact. And same with throwing the smoke here. It's like all these little things, they start to add up. And that's how you become consistent, because you stop allowing yourself to have like weaknesses and flaws and, you know, dents in your armor, basically, with these kind of plays, and you start to not get punished as much. That's like one of the biggest things too. Always be thinking, how do I isolate 1v1s? And a good rule of thumb too is like, if you're down numbers, you can play aggressive and you should be playing aggressive. Like a 2v5, you have to play aggressive and get picks. Otherwise, they're going to pinch you down. If you're up numbers, it's a 5v2. Don't get aggressive. Don't peek. Play the bomb. Play the objective, and you're chilling. Good stuff. And, you know, this will be made to a YouTube video, so you can always go back and check it out in case you were just like, you know, I forgot like 90% of what Joel's taught me. You know, you could always just watch the video again.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. And if you get Thank questions you. Too, yeah, no problem. If you get questions too, you can always DM me. I'm not streaming. Okay. I'll respond pretty quick.